Okay, good morning guys. So today we are discussing about what are the cylindrical grinders and what are the center type cylindrical grinders and internal grinding machines. Okay. So in previous classes we are discussing about the what are the different types of grinding machines, what are the abrasives, what are the different types of abrasives, what are the materials used to make the abrasive particles, okay, what is the working principle of grinding, and what are the types of abrasives, what are the grinding wheels, how it should be manufacturing of grinding wheels. What are the different sizes and the different shapes of the grinding wheels? How it should be selection of grinding wheels? So, what is wheel maintenance and methods of grinding and types of grinding? So, these are all topics we are discussing in the previous classes. So, today we are discussing about the what are the type, what are the center type cylindrical grinding machines and internal grinding machines. So, these two we are discussing in today's class. So we have a different types of grinding machines are there. So there is a grinding machines, it should be a rough grinders and precision grinders. So in that, rough grinders are used to remove the large amount of material without considering the accuracy of parts. Okay, it should be remove the material without the accuracy of parts at high material removal. And the various types of rough grinders are shown in I will show that. So in that grinders, there is a cylindrical grinders and internal grinders. So in these grinders, in the cylindrical grinders, external cylindrical grinders, in the external cylindrical grinders, center type and centerless type, and internal cylindrical grinders. So internal cylindrical is checking type and centerless. So these are the two different types of grindings in the grinding machines. So you can see the introduction of cylindrical grinding is, so what are the different types of operations involved in that, and what are the different types of cylindrical grinding machines is, it should be two different operations. It is a transverse grinding and plunge grinding. So, and the types of cylindrical grinding is a plane center type and a center type universal grinding machine. So these are the two different types of cylindrical grindings. So you can see what is the cylindrical grinding. So in that cylindrical grinding, there is a parallel axis is there. So in that cylindrical grinding, the principle of cylindrical grinder is that the workpiece, it is held between the centers. So it should be rotated a dog or face plate, and rotating the grinding wheel is feed against it. So in that cylinder, there is a two axis. The one is a grinding wheel axis and the another one is workpiece axis. So you can see that axis, there should be a parallel position. Okay, there should be a parallel position. So in that, grinding wheel is rotated and the workpiece should be rotated at opposite, same direction of that workpiece, or removing of metal rate to the infeed. So you can see that there is a infeed is there. How much amount of material to be removed of that workpiece? So it is a 1 mm amount of material or 2 mm amount of material, it should be defined by the, we are giving the infeed, means it means how much amount of depth to be removed on that workpiece. So we can give the infeed at 1 mm. So the 1 mm amount of material should be removed on that workpiece. So we can give the 2 mm of material in that workpiece. So the material should be removed 2 mm depth of the workpiece. Okay. So in that center type, so it should have, the work must be revolved, and the wheel must be revolved. The work must be revolved means the workpiece should be rotated, and the wheel must be revolved means the wheel should be rotated. So the work must pass the wheel, or the wheel must pass the work. So you can see the work must pass the wheel. So the workpiece must passes through the wheel, and the wheel must pass the workpiece, and also the wheel is also moved on the workpiece. So in the two directions are there. Workpiece passed to the wheel, and the wheel is also passed to the workpiece. So you can see the workpiece also rotated and the wheel also be rotated in the center type cylindrical grinding machine. So in the movement of wheel into the work or work into the wheel. So in that machine there is a parallel axis is there. So the work is removed at parallel direction to the faces of that workpiece. Okay. So that is the cylindrical grinding. So you can see. So this is the cylindrical grinding machine. Okay. So in that cylindrical grinding machine, there are different components is there. So one is base, lower table, upper table, tailstock, headstock, grinding wheel, and workpiece. Okay. So and wheel board. So wheel board means to hold the grinding wheel of that workpiece. And the work holding devices, it should be fixed in the headstock and tailstock of the grinding machine. So and the lower table and upper table. So it should be using to move the workpiece at one direction to the another direction. And it should be the workpiece is moved to left and right of that direction. So the base is fixed on that our base on that floor. The base is fixed on that floor. So why the base is using? So the how it should be making? So the base is making to mainly the casting process. In maximum amount of base are making a casting process. Okay. So it should be maintained all amount of all loads should be acting on that base. So it should be acting on very high amount of load on that base. So why? Because the headstock and tailstock and wheel board work, total work on that load is acting only on that base. So in that case, so the base is making in the casting process. It should be a very high amount of load acting on that base. So in that property, we can design the base at very high strength. Okay. So that is the base and the headstock. So it should be the headstock and tailstock are the two fixing devices on that workpiece. Okay. So wheel head. So the headstock, tailstock axis and wheel head axis is parallel to that workpiece, parallel to the grinding wheel and workpiece. Those two are parallel. Okay. So in that material, the material should be removed at step by step by using the infeed. We are giving the infeed. It should be a 1 mm or 2 mm or 0.5 mm or 3 mm. What we are requiring, how much amount of infeed we are giving, that amount of material should be removed on that cylindrical center type grinding machine. Okay. So this is the industrial type cylindrical grinding machine. In industries, these cylindrical grinding machines are used. Okay. What are the types of operations? These types of operations of cylindrical grinding machines is a transfer grinding and plunge grinding. So in the transfer grinding and plunge grinding, it means the transfer or motion means there is a parallel axis of the grinding wheel and the workpiece. So this is the transfer grinding. So it should be, you can see, you can already see the diagram of the cylindrical grinding machine. So this is the transfer grinding machine. This operation is transfer grinding machine. So you can see that. So the method is used when the job length is more than one workpiece is lesser than the width of the grinding wheel. So it means the job length is more than that workpiece. The job length is more than that workpiece, so it is less than the width of grinding wheel. So you can say that grinding wheel So the width of the grinding wheel is lesser than the workpiece. So it should be removed the amount of material by transfer, traverse. So in that direction, the traverse is placed. It should be the grinding wheel moves it at one direction to the another direction. It should be moved on left to right position. So in that case, the material should be equally removed on the workpiece. So the wheel is made to rotate a fixed position. So the wheel should be fixed position. It should not move. So that it should moving on only workpiece. It should be moved at left to right on the workpiece only. So the wheel should be fixed on and what on at one position. So the rotating work made to transfer. The grinding is done by giving longitudinal feed to the grinding wheel. So the grinding is done by the longitudinal feed. So it means the workpiece should be rotated. The workpiece should be rotated and it should be moved to the linear direction of traverse. So it should move at left and right direction of the workpiece. So in that case, in that process, that the material is removed at step by step. We are giving the infeed of depth to the workpiece. How much we are giving, the 1 mm, 2 mm, or 3 mm. So the amount of material should be removed in that transfer grinding of traverse grinding process. Okay. So what is a clump grinding? So this method is when the length of the workpiece is lesser than the width of the grinding wheel. So in it is the length of the workpiece is very less, okay, and the grinding wheel depth should be very high. So you can see the diagram. You can see that diagram A. So the grinding wheel width is very high, and the amount of workpiece should be very less compared to the grinding wheel. So in that cases, the grinding is done by giving only one cross feed, only cross feed to the grinding wheel. So this is known as a pluck grinding. So you can see the difference between the transfer grinding and the pluck grinding. So it is the workpiece should be very length. The grinding wheel width is very low, and the pluck grinding, the workpiece should be very less, and the grinding wheel width is very high. So in that process, the material is removed at only one step, only one cross step. So it should be rotated only across one step. It should be how much amount of material should be removed. Suppose we are removing the material at 5 mm. So we are giving the infeed at 2 mm depth. First we are giving the 2 mm depth. After that we are giving the 2 mm depth. After that we are giving the 1 mm depth. Or else we should giving the 2 mm depth, and otherwise we are giving the 3 mm depth. How much surface finishing factor we are requiring? How much surface finishing is produced on that grinding wheel? So these properties we can maintain to give the infeed of depth to the workpiece. So this is the punch grinding. So in that cylindrical grinding machines, there is a different types. So it should be broadly classified as a plain center type grinding machines and center type universal grinders. So these are the two different types of cylindrical grinding machines. It is a plain center type and universal type grinding machine. So in that plain center type, the grinding machine has, so you can see the plain center type. So the cylindrical grinding machine and plain center type, it is almost to same diagram. So you can see the plain center type, it is a base and adjustable tip and adjustable trip dogs for reversible table reversing lever and movement of the table for feed. So you can see in the previous central cylindrical grinding machine, it should not move on the table. So you can see the plain center type, the table should be moved at a left and right directions of the cylindrical grinding machine. So and the parts are also same. So the headstock is there, tailstock is there, grinding wheel is there, workpiece is there, wheel head is there, and upper table is there, lower table is there. But the difference is the table should be moved at left and right directions of the grinding machine. So these are the parts involved in the plain center type cylindrical grinding machine. And the center type universal grinder. So the universal means it should be rotated at the wheel head is swiveled. The swiveled means the wheel head moves on incline. So the wheel head is moved on inclined position. So it should be maintained at a 10 degrees angle, 15 degrees angle, 45 degrees angle, 60 degrees angle, 75 degrees angle. So the wheel angle should be maintained. So that is the wheel head swivel. So the center type universal grinder. So we can see the universal grinder. It means the wheel head of swivel, it should be inclined motion to be required on that workpiece. Okay. So that is the difference between the plain center type and universal center type grinding machine. So these are the different features involved in the plain center type and universal grinding machine. So the center of headstock spindle can be used as a LIVR head. So the work can be held to revolve by a chucker. So in the central grinding machine, same process is required on the universal center type grinding machine. So in that machine, the wheel head can be swiveled in a horizontal plane in any angle, and it can be fed into the inclined direction also. So the wheel headstock can be swiveled in any angle. So we can see that any angle is placed on the horizontal plane. So we are requiring, suppose at a 45 degrees angle, we are maintaining the 45 degrees angle and we can produce our work. Otherwise, we can maintain the 60 degrees angle. It's a no problem occurred on that machine. So in the universal grinding machine, we are requiring 60 degrees. So we can maintain the 60 degrees angle on that swivel heading tool. So we are maintaining the 60 degrees angle. So the wheel head can also be arranged for internal grinding. So the wheel head is also be arranged on the internal grinding also occurred on the cylindrical grinding machine. So it should be used to both external grinding machines and internal grinding machines. So these are the universal grinding machine. So it is the center type cylindrical grinding. So these are the center type cylindrical grinding machines. And you can see what are the internal grinding machines. So internal grinding, so in the cylindrical grinding, it should be the shape of cylindrical shape. It should be circular or cone shape or cylinder type. So those are all cylindrical grinding. So what are internal grinding machines? So all cylindrical grinding machines are, it should be internal grinders. So used for grinding internal surface of different holes, cylindrical or tapered, etc. So in that cylindrical grinding machines are, should be internal grinders. So it should be the hollow portion on that cylindrical is faced. So it should be the internal grinding is occurred on the cylindrical grinding machine. So that what are the different types of internal grinding machines is, it is a plain internal grinders, universal internal grinders, checking internal grinders, planetary internal grinders, and centernal internal grinders. So these are the different types of internal grinders are involved in the cylindrical grinding machines of internal grindings. So you can see the plain internal grinders. So it carries the individual driven wheel head mounted on a cross slide, and the work should be either a cross check or face plate to be hold on the work. So you can see the diagram. So this is a internal grinding process. So the workpiece should be hollow portion. So that if we are taking one cylinder, the workpiece should be hollow portion. So you can see that work should be rotated and the wheel should be rotated. So the grinding wheel, you can look at the grinding wheel. So it should be rotated. So the workpiece rotated at clockwise direction and the grinding wheel should be rotated at anti-clockwise direction. So the both directions of rotating is opposite directions. So, and you can see the infeed of depth, how much amount of material should be removed. So it is the 1 mm of depth removed or 2 mm amount of depth removed. You can see the infeed of depth and longitudinal traverse. So longitudinal traverse means it should be moved to the left and right direction of the workpiece. So and the spindle, so the work grinding wheel is fixed on that spindle, grinding spindle. So this is the principal internal grinding of the plain internal grinding. So it is the plain internal grinding. It should not, there is a no any angles occurred in the plain internal type. So we can see the only surface finishing factor occurred in the internal grinding machine. Okay, so the universal internal grinding, so it should be very inclined among, so incline is occurred in the grinding machines. So here the work is mounted on a cross slide, which enables the cross feed to the work head. So the work should be cross feed and it should be at some inclined angle is occurred on that work piece. Suppose we are taking one cylinder, it should be after the final output I am making a one cross or cone shaped object. So in that there is a cross face is occurred. So we can view the cross fade. We are maintaining some angles on that cross fade of that internal grinding machine. So the workhead can be swiveled through 90 degrees. So I am taking the universal internal grinding machine. It should be swiveled at 90 degrees or 60 degrees or 180 degrees. In that type of grinding wheel I am taking. So it is used to grind the cylindrical and tapered holes, flat surfaces, outside cylinder surfaces, convex and concave surfaces are occurred in the universal internal grinding machine. So you can see that grinding wheel. So the same operation is occurred, but the swivel operation is there. In the plane center type, there is a no swivel operation is there. There is a swivel operation is there. So in that swivel operation, the tool is moved on the workpiece at some inclined angle. It should be maintained at 90 degrees. So you can maintain the 10 degrees, 20 degrees, 30 degrees, 45 degrees, 90 degrees. So in that requirement, the swivel movement is occurred on the workpiece. Okay. So this is the centerless internal grinders. So if the centerless internal grinders means, so there is a no parallel axis of the workpiece and the cutting tool of the grinding wheel. There is a no parallel axis. It should be some different axis is occurred on the centerless internal grinders. Why? Because the we are taking any workpiece, there is a irregular shapes are occurred in the internal grinding machines, internal cylinders. So there is a no one of the center is there. There is a different centers are occurred in the on the cylinder. So we are maintaining the total surface finishing, and last finally we are occurred in the one center type cylindrical grinding machine. So we are taking the centerless internal grinding operations. So the workpiece is supported between the three roles known as pressure roll, supporting roll, and a regulating roll. So these roles, while supporting the workpiece, also rotated the same. It should be the same direction of the workpiece, and all roles should be same direction while the workpiece and grinding rotated is the opposite direction. So these directions we are obtaining the surface finishing factor of the workpiece on the cutting tool. Okay, so the grinding wheel remains contact with the internal surface of the workpiece at the horizontal center line of regulating wheel. So the grinding wheel remains contact with the internal surface. So that means the grinding wheel should always interact with the workpiece. So it should be amount of material and there is a irregular shapes are occurred. It should be removing step by step after the final we get the our final output of the total surface finishing factor of the workpiece. So that is the centerless internal grinders. So you can see the diagram. There is a centerless internal grinding operation. So you can see that the grinding wheel and you can see that workpiece. So there is no one centered occurs. So the grinding wheel axis is different. The grinding, the workpiece axis is different. And the supporting roles, these are the different supporting roles, the pressure role, supporting role, regulating wheel. These wheels we are occurred and final output we are taking the centerless internal grinding machine process. We are finally occurred own workpiece of the internal grinding operation of the centerless. Okay. And next one, the planetary internal grinders. Planetary internal grinders, these are also a reciprocating movement of the grinding wheel spindle, and it should be large, irregular shaped and heavy workpiece. The workpiece remains stationary, which is mounted on a slide. Okay, these are also internal grinding operation of the centerless center type operation. So you can see the planetary internal grinding we will discuss later in this topic. Okay, so these are the operations of center type cylindrical grinders and internal grinding machines of the types of grinding machines. Okay, so in our further classes we will discuss what are the centerless grinding machines and internal centerless grinding machines, surface grinding machines. We will discuss later. Okay, thank you guys.